Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Professor Kulbhushan Chandel from Himachal Pradesh University, Shimla. Today we are going to talk on module Branding and Positioning, Packaging and Labeling from paper Marketing Management. Let me discuss that what we are going to learn from this module. We will be defining the concept of branding, labeling, positioning, and packaging. We will be explaining the needs of branding, labeling, positioning, and packaging. We will be focusing upon the importance of these elements in marketing process. And finally, we will be defining the need of these elements to the marketers. Let me introduce the topic. The customer never buys the product only. He buys a product what gives him group of value of satisfactions and the total package of expectations and benefits too. The various components of the total product personality are product image, branding, packaging, guarantee, warranty, after sale services, labeling, and positioning. Packaging. The package of a product is an important mean of product identification. The importance of packaging is increasing day by day. The sales are increased through the use of attractive packages. The basic motive of packaging is to protect the product from rough handling and weathers. But it should keep in mind that the cost of packaging should never exceed the cost of production. The expenditure on packaging can be as much as it can be, but its cost exceeds the cost of production. It may be out of the reach of many customers. According to W.J. Stanton, packaging is the general group of activities which concentrate in formulating the design of a package and producing an appropriate and attractive container or wrapper for the product. Package helps the customer to make decisions as it provides the assurance regarding the authenticity of the product and its usefulness. It also helps in distinguishing the product from that of the competitors. The decorative appearance of the package helps in getting attention of the consumers. The package is also necessary to provide a convenient handling. It prevents the liquid to flow out, maintaining the freshness and the quality. The package of the product is a silent salesman, if we say. Good packaging. Good packaging is very important as it is the first thing seen by the customer. The following aspects of packaging can impress a person to buy the product. It should be protective. It should also be convenient to handle. It should provide information regarding product. It should be attractive too. It should be environmental friendly and pollution free also. Durable, lightweight, and have the clean look. Simple in design and should be catchy to the eyes, should be innovative, and people should like it to possess.
let me discuss that how to do the packaging. It starts right from design, then the size, the cost, and the test that matter while designing, making the size, or doing the packaging aspects. Design. The first step is designing of the packaging. The production team should handle the design of the package most effectively. The outlook of package, material used, information about the product, etc., should be taken into the consideration. Customers are judgmental and are easily attracted by the product's packaging. Size. Size is the next step which needs attention of the production department. The size of packaging depends upon the size of the product. The bigger the product, the bigger the packaging, and vice versa. A product has number of sizes, so the packaging has to be designed in accordance to the size of the product. Cost. The organization keeps in mind that the cost of packaging is charged along the product. That should be minimum. Test. Finally, the tests they are taken to ensure the packaging is up to the mark that the organization has laid. And test can be related to the suitability of the packaging and regaining the effectiveness of packaging.
Kinds of packaging. Various factors like nature of content, requirement of the distribution, possible kind of handling, and many other factors decide what kind of packaging is to be done. And the kinds of packagings may be described like the distribution packaging. The distribution packaging means to protect the content starting from the production to the consumption. This kind of packaging preserves the product from damaging it, has passed many quality tests. Then the consumer packaging. Consumer packaging is useful only when it covers the required details of which provide the sufficient information also. Then the identical packaging. Identical packaging is done for the branded products. It is benefiting for some kind of products or brands. It is also known as economical packaging. Then comes the multiple purpose packaging. Multi-purpose packaging is done where the heterogeneous or the homogeneous unit of products are placed in a single container. Then the reuse packaging. Throw me not or reuse packaging is most suitable among household items like ghee, sugar, coffee, tea, and so on, where the customer can reuse the containers. Packaging should be strong so that it could preserve the products for longer time.
Advantages of packaging. The advantages of packaging can be discussed by three ways. The advantages to the manufacturers, advantages to the middlemen, and the advantages to the customers. While discussing the advantages to the manufacturers, it includes that the product reaches to the manufacturers safely. It facilitates the manufacturers in storage. It enhances the goodwill of the manufacturers also. It prevents the adulterations. It's helpful in advertising and sales promotion. And finally, it increases the profitability of the manufacturers. As far as the advantages of packaging to the middleman is concerned, it facilitates the storage facilities to the middleman. It is itself a self-advertising, easily displayed. It helps the middleman while in transit. It is in transit, and it do help the middlemen in increasing the sales and profits. While discussing the advantages of packaging to the consumers, the minimum possible adulteration that happens if good packaging is there, the convenient handling that is possible, and it provides the required information to the customers. It protects the contents and the payment of appropriate price to the packaging. Branding. According to the American Merchandising Association, American Marketing Association, a brand is name, term, symbol, or a design, or a combination of them, which is intended to identify the goods or services of one seller or group of sellers and to differentiate them from those of the competitors. On the other hand, branding is a process of finding and fixing the means of identification. A brand is a name or mark or symbol, numbers or letters or any other word or combination of these given to a product in order to get a separate entity of the product. A brand is an integral part of the symbol appearing on the product. A buyer identifies the product with a brand name, and the seller gets a chance to earn goodwill in the market. For example, in shampoo, there is a Dove, Sunsilk, Pantene, Head & Shoulders, etc. And as far as the soap are concerned, Lux is there, Rexona is there, Pond's is there, and Pears, and so on, and number of brand names are there. Types of brands or kinds of brands. Brands can be classified on various basis. On the basis of ownership, when we are discussing, there is a manufacturer brand, a brand which is owned by the manufacturer and registered as a trademark under manufacturer's name is known as manufacturer's brand. Middleman brand. It is that brand which is owned by the middleman or is registered under his name. While classifying the brand on the basis of market area, there may be the local brand. When a brand is used in a particular market area, it is called local brand. The regional brand. When the manufacturer segments the market into different regions of a nation and different brand names are used for the different regions, it is called regional brand. And when the manufacturer uses single brand for marketing his products in whole of the market, it is known as national brand. Then the international brand, when the manufacturer uses particular brand for marketing his product at international level, it is known as international brand. We can classify brands on the basis of number of products. It includes the family brand. When the manufacturer uses single brand for all its products and in all market segments, it is known as family brand. individual brand. When the manufacturer separates the brand name for each product manufactured by him, it is known as individual brand. Product line brand. When a business house uses different brands for its different product lines, it is known as product line brand. We can classify the brands on the basis of its use. Fighting brand. When there is a very tough competition in the market and the manufacturer wants to introduce a low-priced new product to fight the competition, the brand name which is used for such product is known as fighting brand. Competitive brand. When difference in the products of different manufacturers available in the market is not significant, the brand name of such type of products are known as competitive brands. Multiple brands. When the manufacturer offers the products that appeals to basically the same customers under different brands, it is called as multiple branding. Let me discuss the advantages of branding. The advantages of brandings may be categorized in a number of ways. Advantages to the manufacturer, advantages to the middlemen, advantages to the customers. When we are discussing the advantages to the manufacturers, it helps to procure orders. It makes the identity separate. It is useful for the related product. It helps in the repeat sales, helpful in direct selling. A regular production happens possible. It generates the brand loyalty among the customers, and it makes the manufacturers easy to face the competition. As far as the advantages of brand to the middleman is concerned, the less chances of risk that happen possible. It requires less efforts by the middleman. It facilitates the quick sale. It enhances the goodwill of middleman. It facilitates the publicity programs. While discussing the advantages of brands to the consumers, it includes the strong confidence in the mind of the customers. Goods are easily available to the customers. It minimizes the possibility of adulteration. It is economical too. The prices are fixed. Factors leading to the creation of strong brands. There are many brands which are different from other brands, and the consumers prefer them more than other brands. These brand names become famous and beneficial for the firm, and the risk of being replaced by their competitors shatter down. Sometimes a brand is associated with a particular area which can be very helpful in attaining a strong position in the market. Branding is a managerial function. It is a general term covering various activities such as giving brand name to the product, designing a brand mark, establishing and popularizing it. The following factors are some factors which should be considered for selecting and deciding the brand name of the product. The brand name should be simple, short, and sweet. It should be easily pronounceable. It should be recognizable. the brand name should be suggestive. The brand name should also be legally protective, and it should be helpful in advertising the products.
Limitations of branding. Although branding has many advantages for manufacturer, middlemen, consumers, but it also has some limitations which can be explained as under. Premium brands vary. There are many products like fruits and vegetables for which the branding cannot be done. And branding enhances the monopoly to the great extent.
Labeling. Labeling is an important means of product identification, like branding and packaging. Labeling is the act of attaching the labels to the products. Packages and their labels should give buyers accurate information about the contents and necessary guidance regarding the use of the product. As per Food, Drug and Cosmetic Act passed in 1938 that applies on cosmetics and medicines as well as food and drugs, that states quantity of contents, that includes the liquid measurements, numerical terms, stated label, that name and the address of the owners. Label contains clear description of flavorings and color preservatives or materials in the containers. Label should be legal and must have justifiable claims. Warnings of the contents contained in the product must be stated in the label. A good label is the one which helps the potential buyer to make his decision and provides the following information: brand name of the product, trademark of the company, name and address of the manufacturer, ingredients of the product, weight, measures, counts, etc., directions for the use of the product, precautionary measures of the product, date of manufacturing and date of expiry, maximum retail price, statutory warnings, if any. Methods of labeling informations. It includes grade labeling, descriptive labeling, and combination labels. Grade labeling. When the product is graded in accordance to its standard quality, then the grade labeling is used. This policy is popular in canned fruit and vegetable industries. The Production and Marketing Administration makes continuous inspection to packers and canners under which products are inspected and graded according to agencies' previously established quality standard. Inspectors rate and grade product according to its color, uniformity of size and symmetry, deletes defects and clearness of liquids. A grade level specifies the quality or standards of the product, such as A grade, fancy, large, medium, small, etc. Descriptive labeling. These labels are descriptive in nature. These labels provide full information to consumers about the product and the producers. It indicates objective information regarding contents, uses, precautions, quantity, quality, date of manufacturing, etc. A descriptive label is generally in the printed form and provides full information about the product. The pharmaceuticals and cosmetics companies use descriptive labels. Combination labels. These are the combination of above two labels. The use of such labels is rapidly increasing. Positioning. According to Roger Reeves, positioning is that is an art of finding out number of unique selling propositions, the one which will give you maximum sales. Positioning is the plan or the benefit of the product. Some authors describe it as image, and some describe as status in the market, and various authors equate it with brand personality. Positioning is main decisions from which all other marketing and advertising decisions they are taken. It is an integrating concept which helps to provide direction and force to marketing and advertising planning, and also integrates various elements of the marketing mix. It is the task of marketing planners and advertising strategists to design each element of marketing mix to serve the positioning objectives of the brand. The position of brand is its mass. This perception is based on its functional attributes and benefits like tasty, sporty, and roomy, as well as it is also based on non-functional or emotional associations like reliable, traditional, smart, prestigious, modern, and so on. Thus, the positioning of brand can be stated as the perception which remains in the minds of the target consumers, which reflects functional and non-functional benefits. The main thought behind the positioning is the idea that relating to product and brand that occupies a special or particular space remains continuously in the consumer's mind. It is called renting mind space. For example, soya milk as health drink. Complaint is positioned as health builder. Limca is positioned as thirst quenching soft drink. The components of positioning, which includes the product class, the consumer segmentation, consumer perception or perpetual mapping, benefits offered by the brand. Product class. A product class can be defined as the set of products or brands which are perceived as substitutes to satisfy consumer needs. For example, the product class of chocolates, Cadbury, Amul, and Campas are clearly positioned against one another. The product class of festival seasons, gifts, consumers may position in a decorative box of the chocolates. Consumer segmentation. In this competitive world, every producer has to find their closest competitor and should also be able to identify the various segments in which their brand can survive. Positioning of the brand and the target segment produced must be combined, because brand must be positioned to appeal to the target consumer segment and respond to the brand that occupies the position preferred by it. Target market and positioning strategies are just similar to two sides of a coin. Consumer perception and perceptual mapping. Perceptual mapping means representing consumer perceptions in two-dimensional space so that the manager can readily see where his own brand prospect and in relation to other brand. Consumers are asked to rate a set of brands along with given attributes or benefits, or they may be asked merely to judge by peers how similar or dissimilar the brands are. There are various techniques available for such perceptual mapping. Profile charts are fairly common in India. Research organizations offer hierarchical clusters analysis, multiple discriminate analysis, and some applications has also been reported in conjoint analysis. Brand attributes and benefits. The brand that must offer a benefit which is important to the customers. For example, perceptual map showing the benefits offered by different washing products. Robin Liquid is attempting to distinguish itself from from detergent products on the dimension of extra whiteness. Consumers can express preferences only in terms of benefits, how much they are obtaining a specific benefit from existing brands, how important that this benefit is to them, whether there is some benefit which they are missing, whether they would prefer to obtain a specific benefit in greater or lesser measure. Such preferences are also called ideal point when plotted on a perceptual map.
So the students, let's now summarize what we have learned from this very module. We have learned that the customer never buy the products only. He buy the products which gives him group of values of satisfaction and the total package of expectations and benefits. The various components of the total product personality are product image, branding, packaging, guarantee, after sale services, and so on. The basic motive of packaging is to secure the product from rough handling and from the weather. But only it should keep be kept in the mind that the cost of packaging should never exceed the cost of production. The expenditure on packaging can be as much as it can, but its cost exceed the cost of production, it may be out of the reach of many customers. Packaging plays a vital role in sale of product, but it does not mean that the form can provide bad quality. It includes the product information, the guarantee that the product is just good, or good packaging is very important as it is the first thing seen by the customer. The main aspect of the packaging which can impress a person to buy the product are the information regarding the product. A variety of factors like nature of contents, requirements of distribution, possible kind of handling, and many other factors decide what kind of packaging is to be done. And distribution packaging do means to protect the contents starting from the production to the consumption. These kind of packagings preserve the product from damaging it as it has passed through many quality tests. Consumer packaging is useful only when it covers the required details and provide sufficient information. Identical packaging is done for the branded products. It is benefiting for same kind of products or brands. It is also known as economical packaging. Multi-purpose packaging is done where the heterogeneous or the homogeneous units of products are placed in the single container. Throw-me-not or reuse packaging is most suitable among household items like ghee, sugar, coffee, etc., where the customers can reuse the containers. We have also learned that packaging should be strong so that it could preserve the product for a long time. Moreover, we have learned that brand is a name or mark or symbol, number, letter, or any other word or combination of these given to a product in order to get the separate entity of the product. Some examples like Dove, Sunsilk, Pantene, and so on. There are many brands which are distinct from other brands, and the consumers prefer them more than other brands. These brands' names become famous and beneficial for firm, and the risk of being replaced by their competitors shutter down. We have also learned that sometimes a brand is associated with the particular area which can be very helpful in attaining the strong position in the market. There are many factors which can increase the employee's interest in promoting the brands. While formulating labeling policies, we have learned from this module that requires what and how much information should be included on the label and the way of presentation we have learned. The manufacturer should not underestimate the fact that the consumers normally know a very little about the product. There is a difference between what manufacturers and what consumers know. In labeling, problems are not undertaken by the legislation. So the best rule to follow is to include the type of information. Consider the amount of interest that is desired by the mass the commerce. After describing the type and amount of information to be included on that label, the next question arises, which we have learned is relating to the information to be presented. The main steps which present the data in the meaningful form to the customers. We have learned from this module that there are two methods of labeling information: grading levels and descriptive labeling. Grade labeling is done when product is graded according to its standard quality. Then we will use grade labeling. This policy is popular in canned fruit and vegetable industries, we have came to know. And we have also known, came to know from this very module, that grade labeling is done for differentiating quality levels from each others of the grade labeling assigned to more products. The prices of completing brand leads to vary more according to the quality. Small packers and canners should benefit who find it impossible to carry on the consumer advertising. Large canners and packers, advertising agencies, some trade associates, and majority of the canning industries are against the labeling. We came to know that descriptive labeling includes the labeling in printing upon the level of ingredients, weight, size, direction of use, and so on. The main emphasis is to provide consumer with information they need to judge the relevance and appropriateness of the product. Finally, we learned from this very particular module the positioning. The positioning is the proposition or the benefit of the product. For some authors, it is its image, and for some, its status in the market, and other authors equate it with the brand personality. Positioning is main decisions from which all other marketing and advertising decisions they are taken. It is fountainhead decisions as well as the integrating concept. It helps to provide the direction and thrust to the marketing and advertising planning. If we say that it is the task of the marketing planner and the advertising strategist to design each element of marketing mix to serve the positioning objectives of the brand, it would not be wrong.